I am Christelle from Diabetes Strong, and today I'm gonna show you where on your body you can place a Dexcom CGM. So a little bit of warning here, a lot of the placements I'm gonna be showing you today are considered off-label. That means that if you choose to place your sensor in a place that's not approved in your region, it's considered off-label and the manufacturer, Dexcom, is not necessarily liable should the product malfunction. I'll be telling you which placements are considered off-label and which are not. So let's talk a little bit more about where the Dexcom CGM sensor is approved to be worn. So in the US, the Dexcom G6 is approved by the FDA to be worn on the abdomen, and that's for the ages 2 and up, as well as at the upper buttocks, and that's for the ages 2 to 17. That's the FDA label for that. What that means is that Dexcom has done the research and they submitted the clinical data to FDA and had that approved. That is a safe place to wear the sensor. Interestingly enough, here in the US, there's also other sensors available. Medtronic has one, Abbott has a Libre sensor, and those are both approved for wear on the arm. So, but in the US, it's currently only approved for abdomen and upper buttocks if the patient is younger. Anyway, in Europe, Dexcom received CE mark in June of 2020 for wear on the arm as well as the abdomen. So that means if you are in Europe or a country that uses a CE marking as a guidance, the product is actually worn as approved for being worn on both the stomach as well as on the arm. Okay, so I'm in the US. This is where I live. I like to wear my sensor on my arm, but because I'm here and it's not a CE country, it is technically considered off-label. Dexcom can be placed in most reasonable places below the neckline where it feels comfortable. Generally, it's not recommended, however, that you place directly over bone or very muscular areas. Try and find somewhere that's a little, what I call meatier, or has a little bit more fatty tissue. So let me show you a few places where the Dexcom can be worn. I've been wearing the Dexcom sensors for quite a few years now, coming up to 5 years, and I've worn them quite a few places. So the first one is FDA approved on the abdomen, on the stomach. See a photo of that here. Another placement is my thighs. So that goes here. That's not my favorite placement just because that's a little bit of a more muscular area for me. I've also worn it on my lower back. See it here. I don't mind that placement except if there are a period of times where I drive a lot, I find it's a little uncomfortable sitting up against a car seat when the sensor's placed there. And then this is my favorite placement, seat here or here. This is my upper arm. This is where I prefer to wear my Dexcom. It doesn't get in the way. I get the absolute best readings there. I place it below the delt. Okay. So the shoulder muscle. So it's kind of, yeah. As I said, a little more meatier area, so I don't feel any pain when I insert that. But those are the only real places that I've ever tried it. I've seen people place it pretty much anywhere below the neckline. A lot of it looks very uncomfortable to me. I will not be trying that out for you. However, my friend Connie allowed me to use a few photos of some of the placements that she has tried and that she's liked. So let's bring out Connie. So this is the first one. And you can see here, Connie is wearing it on her arm, on her forearm. Again, that is a more muscular area. You don't have a lot of fatty tissue there. So I have seen some people who sort of commented that they can feel the sensor, or at least they have the sense that they can feel the sensor. Next one is on the calf. Another place I won't be trying, but I've seen a lot of people really love this placement. Again, you might feel some discomfort given it's kind of directly into a muscle, but people say it doesn't get in the way, which I can see because it's there, and they get really good readings. My recommendation when it comes to the placement of the Dexcom CGM is know what you're comfortable with. Are you comfortable with off-label or are you not? If you're not comfortable with off-label, that's totally fine. If you're in the US, just stay with abdomen. And if you're in Europe, you can do abdomen or the arm. And you'll be, you know, still using it as directed. If you are comfortable going off-label, what I would suggest is start out with again, a meatier place. I wouldn't necessarily go directly to injecting the sensor into a muscle. So start with a meatier place and try different things out and spread it out. Don't necessarily place it exactly where you usually do your injections. Okay, we don't want to inject and have our sensors in the same place. So using the product off-label also means, at least for me, that I can move it around and keep it away from my injection sites. I hope this video is helpful, that you got some ideas for new placements for your sensor. Thank you so much for watching.